Hello and welcome to Nightly News on CAA.
I'm Camille Jones.
And I'm Sam Handler. By the way,
Happy New Year's Eve!
I can't believe it's 1959.
I know! And as this year is coming to a close, we reflect on the highlights of this decade.
We will be exploring the artists, celebrities, and trends that impacted our culture.
Let's look back at the 1950s.
On June 25th, 1950, the Korean War began. It was a three-year-long war. It was a constant struggle to define the border between North and South Korea. U.S. troops supported South Korea over communist North Korea. The war ended in a stalemate. Even now, North and South Korea are still split.
On June 17, 1955, Walt Disney, who's already gaining popularity from years of making movies, opened his theme park in Anaheim, California. The streets were packed, leading to a chaotic opening day. Disney had incorporated organized ticket books for rides, and just this year introduced the e-ticket for the most popular attractions in the park.
On October 4, 1957, the Soviet Union launched Sputnik, the world's first artificial satellite. The launch impacted everyone. The United States feared the Soviets' ability to spy on America, and Sputnik increased their technical advancements.
Yes, and because this happened, the race to space began. President Eisenhower signed the National Aeronautics and Space Act, allowing the United States to research space and the Earth's atmosphere. The organization called NASA began operating on October 1, 1958.
The United States acquired Alaska and Hawaii this year. On January 3, 1959, Alaska became the 49th state. In August, Hawaii was granted statehood, becoming the 50th state in America.
Now to Emma
with movies and television.
The 1950s were a great time for movies. I'm Emma Willis, and we'll be examining some of them right now.
Arguably, the company with the most success would of course be the Disney Company. The much-anticipated opening of Walt Disney's theme park in 1955 boosted his popularity. The Mickey Mouse Club and Walt Disney's Disneyland were two shows that both aired on ABC. These movies released by Disney were all box office successes. In 1951, the Best Picture Award goes to An American in Paris, directed by Vincent Minnelli, starring Gene Kelly, Leslie Caron, and Oscar Levant. This musical movie revolves around two friends looking for work in Paris. Their lives are about to get complicated when love enters the picture. Everybody loved Lucy. From her first season of Six in 1951, America was enthralled with this charming lady. No surprise, too. Her exuberant personality got I Love Lucy the title of most watched show in America. Starring primarily Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz, this hilarious sitcom's runtime on CBS was from October 1951 to May 1957. No matter what your favorite programs and movies are, from All About Eve to White Christmas, from The Ed Sullivan Show to The Twilight Zone, I think we can all agree, even after the end of this decade, our love for these cinematic wonders will live on.
Singin' in the Rain is one of my favorites.
That's a great movie. And after looking back at all the movies from the decade, let's go to Connor with art.
Hi, I'm Connor, and I'm here to tell you about the art from this decade. The 1950s, that is, of course.
The first art piece everyone knows and loves is Funhouse. This piece was created in 1956 and was one of the greatest critical successes of the 1956 Whitechapel Exhibition. This is because it was one of the earliest installations of pop art. Hamilton, the artist, collabed with John Volker, an architect, to create this giant structure of art. The reason this piece was so prominent was because it was one of the first pieces to start the pop art craze. The next beautiful and famous piece is The Cyclops. This piece was created by Eduardo Pelosi and was made in 1957. This piece was famous for how it could be both melancholy and complex. This piece is made of bronze, giving it a rusted, decayed look. One could say this piece represented a man in the nuclear era, great but can be reduced to a dilapidated state. The last piece is the Hudson River Landscape. This sculpture was created by David Smith in 1951 and was known for turning abstract expressionism from painting to sculpture. This piece was a breakthrough because its inspiration was a landscape, not a figure. One prominent artist of our decade is David Smith. You may remember him from the Hudson River landscape. David was known for using metal as a medium for sculpting. This unorthodox style gained him fame.
It's amazing to see all the talent we have in this country.
It really is. And we will look back on everything that you might have missed after the break.
What's this?
It's a Swanson Turkey TV dinner.
It's fast, easy, and simple. Now I have more time to iron your clothes.
That's right.
The Swanson TV Turkey Dinner is a three-course meal in one convenient package. It's ready in just 25 minutes. Perfect for watching TV.
Cool, Daddy-O. We're a family that watches TV.
There's nothing better than being a family that watches TV while eating together.
Make sure you stop by your local Five and Dime to buy your whole family Swanson TV Turkey Dinners. I know she sure likes them.
It's 7 o'clock! Switch the channel! It's time to watch The Honeymooners!
Alright, folks. I'm blowing this popsicle stand.
Welcome back!
And now we're going to go to Eloisa with music.
Thanks, Sam. Hello, I'm Eloisa Hernandez, and I'll be telling you about the rockin' and rolling music of the 1950s.
A new type of music has been taking over the country. Rock and roll is a mixture of rhythm and blues that was first introduced to America by Alan Freed on the WJW radio station. From then on, people like Chuck Berry, Bill Haley, and Elvis Presley have been providing enjoyment to the U.S. In 1955, Bill Haley and his Comets came out with Rock Around the Clock and quickly became number one on the Billboard charts. Another rising star, Chuck Berry, released Johnny B. Goode in 1958, which he wrote about himself and his life growing up.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl, crying all the time.
Elvis Presley is a rock and roll icon. He released his first single, That's Alright, in 1954. His first number one hit, Heartbreak Hotel, in 55. Since then, he's had all the girls falling for him. His most recent songs are Jailhouse Rock and Hound Dog. Not only do his songs hypnotize the ladies, but also his sexual dancing. Because of the dancing and lyrics, many parents think rock and roll is taboo, but we just see youth having fun. Parents think their children will become rebellious and delinquents, but what they need to do is hop onto the rock and roll train. Back to you, ladies.
Elvis sure does make me want to get up and start dancing.
We don't need to see that. Now moving on to Nick with literature.
I'm Nick Ciccone, and I'm going to be talking about the literature from the 1950s. The Catcher in the Rye was written in 1951 by Nobel Prize winner J.D. Salinger. It was extremely controversial at first because people considered the book to be communist or had too many crude parts. Fahrenheit is a dystopian novel by Ray Bradbury. The novel presents a society where books are outlawed and firemen burn the found books. This book brought fear to people because they thought that it promoted book burning and it showed a government in which the government controls the masses, which could be an eye-opener to many people. Invisible Man is a book written by Ralph Ellison about a man whose skin color renders him invisible in modern society. This book blew up and was a major eye-opener in showing some struggles faced by African-American men.
I might just buy that book.
Next, Sam is going to tell us about photography. Go ahead, Sam. Tell us.
Now I'm going to tell you guys about photography.
In this decade is when the photography industry started booming. Photography is a way we have been able to document and show how our culture is, the celebrities we adore, and the trends that we've set and continued, and the art we've created. It has shown the difference in our society rules
such as the Sochs and the Greasers. Sochs were considered more classy and were into school more, as for the Greasers were otherwise. An example of a famous photographer in this past era would be a photographer by the name of Robert Frank. Some examples of his work are elevator, parade, trolley, San Francisco, and Charleston, South Carolina.
Thank you all for joining us on this New Year's edition of CAA News.
10 seconds till the ball drops. 5,
4,
3,
2,
1.